radio room. You can stick your head out. That's another place you can climb out. We'll talk about that. And then also there's a door in the front. So just follow a crew member if you have to run away bravely from the airplane on the ground. So I'll be the one running the fastest. So you guys can try to catch one of us too here. We have to get away from the airplane on that. The airplane is a limited category aircraft. Really what that means is it's just like a standard category airplane. So it doesn't meet the same manufacturing standards. The FAA deems us very safe to do. That's why they allow us to do it. We have a special exemption that allows us to fly passengers, and they set the rules and the training that allows us to do this. So it's a privilege that we're able to do it, keep the airplane flying. Very safe airplane. So if we shut an engine off in flight, you'd never know it. This thing, the book says it'll fly on one. I don't try that, but it flies on three just like it has all four, and we're quite light. We don't get shot at. We don't have the bullets and the bombs and all that. We don't run into combat loads anymore for that. So very, very safe airplane to go fly. About the flight, you're only going to be sat down for takeoff and landing. So one person will be up in the front with Ashley. Three people will be in the radio room. And then the other three or four, whatever, even seven, will be back here in the back in the waist. As soon as we break down, the engine's running good. I mean, immediately, look to her. She's going to give you a thumbs up. You guys can unbelt and run and play. When you're running, you will bump your head in this plane. So, yo, it's $1 every time you bump your head. So just give that to the tape when you come out. But I've flown it for over 20 years. If I had a dollar for every time I bumped my head, I'd have my own V-17. So just go very slow. I still bump my head when I walk through this thing. I have no idea why I don't. I'm not smart enough to duck. But when you're walking through things, you're going through the bomb bay, and you lift your head up, you will hit your head. So be careful of that. But anyway, you're up for the entire time for the flight. Just be careful and take your time going through. We'll show you where the six acts are there in the radio room. Every once in a while, somebody gets queasy. So if you're getting ready to spew, that's not the good time to look for the six act. At that point, it's usually too late. So tuck your shirt in. This is good. Or just throw up right there so Mike can clean it up after the flight. So be careful on that as well. If you get queasy, just go get that. But it should be an issue for that. If we have any problems, we'll tell Ashley. She'll tell you guys to take your seats. We want you up for the max amount of time possible. So everybody wants to be in the nose, and that's so that you guys can shoot into the nose. Three people comfortably fit up there. But before we land, you can't be in the nose for landing. We have a bailout bell, so I'll ring that bell, and that gives you about 2 minutes to get your seat. Again, don't take off running. We'll give you plenty of time, and we'll extend it, because I can look back and see where people are taking the seat. Usually people sit down within 30 seconds. So, but anyway, if you're any slow movers, we'll give you enough time.